geopolitically. We've seen when it comes to war, the U.S. does whatever it wants and only wants a rules-based order to restrain other states. But that seems to be an issue with the economy, the global economy, as well. And I think that's part of why the hypocrisy issue is relevant far beyond just simply pointing out that the U.S. can't be trusted to be restrained by its own rules. Other countries see this. That's the important implication, too. And there have been actually quite a number of articles that have come out, Wall Street Journal, Foreign Policy, where people are pointing out is that there's this sort of navel-gazing habit among people in the West to regard consensus in the West as global consensus. So, hey, I went to a NATO meeting and all my friends agreed with me. So I guess the whole world agrees with me. And we're seeing increasing examples of the fact that, no, actually, countries that represent more than half the world's population aren't backing the U.S.'s economic jihad against Russia. Latin America has straight up said it's not interested in sanctions. Africa, not interested. And then a lot of these countries depend heavily on Russian wheat and Russian oil. And much of the world depends on Russian minerals and other important factors like fertilizer. So what the U.S. is now saying is that, well, our made-up rules-based order demands that all you other countries impoverish yourself in order to fit this higher goal that the United States has decided is of utmost importance. So apparently people in Argentina are supposed to view impoverishing themselves as, you know, just a few cracked eggs in the omelet of suppressing Russian aggression, which of course is basically of no relevance to people in sub-Saharan Africa who are more interested in getting food.